Hi, this is Greg Wong at Advanced Thermal Solutions, and in this video we're going to demonstrate what we can do with thermochromic liquid crystals. In this video, we're showing a power regulator board that has a heat generating component near the center. This component is generating, is dissipating about 3 watts, and this board we've sprayed with several fine coats of black ink. And then we spray it with several fine coats of thermochromic liquid crystals. In this case, it has a bandwidth of 40 to 60 degrees Celsius, which means that below that temperature and above that temperature, the liquid crystals are clear. So that's what you see now. So we're just starting to see some of the liquid crystal come into range on the right side of the component. And then you can also see it looks like heat is also being generated from a distinct point on the left side of that component. So the red has indicated that it's just about 40 degrees C. And you can see that right on component, it's already starting to turn into the green range. So these colors do follow the range of the spectrum, you know, red, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and then after which it will turn transparent again. But now the component is uniformly green, and you can see the heat spreading along one of the copper planes in the PCB. So you can, along the right side there, you can see a sharp cutoff, which indicates the shape of the copper plane there. You can see the passive components, capacitors, also heating up, and the area is spreading downwards. And now on the component, we can just start to see thermochromic liquid crystals turning blue, which is indicating it's nearing the top of the temperature range. And down at the bottom now, you can see sharp outlines from the shapes of various ground planes. And it looks like at the bottom of the PCB, where the shape is a little bit more diffuse, there could be a copper plane that's deeper on the PCB, so it's not as sharply defined as the other ones that you see. So this does show relative temperature differences. Again, the bandwidth for this thermochromic liquid crystal is 40 to 60 degrees C. And right on the component there, it has just exceeded the bandwidth, which is the small area that's turned black. So yeah, it definitely seems like there are two distinct areas on this component where heat is being generated. And with the liquid crystals, you can evaluate for absolute temperatures, but you do need a specialized system with a camera and controlled lighting. And the camera needs to be hooked up with a computer, and you need a temperature calibration head. And what you would do is spray the same liquid crystals onto the calibration head, and then you would bring the calibration head to a certain temperature, and the computer would then generate a calibration curve depending on the color of the liquid crystal for a given temperature. And then when the camera looks at the device under test, then it can translate the different wavelength colors to particular temperatures. But in this case, we can still see a lot visually, just in terms of how the heat spreads. So at this point, the evaluation board has been powered up for about 6 minutes, and we can see that almost all of the board has reached the lower limit of the TLC, and that's the cooling cycle. So if you have any questions about this video or about our liquid thermochromic liquid crystals, please don't hesitate to contact us through our website at www.qats.com.